What's good, everyone? It's your boy, yadiiiig, 4 eyes, 2 J's here, and flashback to when the Uzi community was in the midst of the EA drought. There was a lot of talk from people that Uzi was done, he was finished, he'd fallen off, he'd taken too long, but Uzi has turned around and proven once again he is one of the mainstay artists of this generation. The numbers have come in courtesy of hits double daily, and they're really surprising to me, and I almost can't believe it.
Shawty acting crazy, I wonder why she heard. God's little angel, shawty putting in that word, but she calling on my phone. Goofy shawty start to flirt. Oh, making moves, working through my sleeve. Yeah, I'm asking who are you? Oh, what it do? GP27, shawty start to me like go.
So hits double daily have projected him to do 275 to 325k. First week. This is a ridiculously big W. Like, I'm so surprised. If you guys tuned into my live stream the other day, I was saying that I think Uzi would do around 150-ish K first week, but I will happily admit that I was very off with this one, and I'm happy to be. For some context to understand the enormity of these numbers, let's compare this to other recent drops from people. And keep in mind that at the moment on Spotify, Uzi only has roughly 16 to 17 million monthly listeners. We can see Lil Baby here, who had roughly 20 mil Spotify listeners at the time of his release, did 188k first week. DaBaby, who had 16 million listeners at the time of release, did 145k. And A Boogie, who had roughly 21 million at the time of release, did 111k first week. And then you have releases from other years like ASAP Rocky, Playboi Carti, Lil Yachty, etc, etc, who all did less than 100k with their recent releases. So putting Uzi's numbers into context, we can see that he's done exceptionally well compared to others. And even compared to his Love Is Rage 2 numbers, which was 135k, he is almost certainly going to double them. So this is a huge W all round. And part of this success is due to the huge push and placements he's been receiving from streaming services. We see him be the face of the Rap Caviar playlist, which is one of the biggest Spotify playlists there is, as well as him having countless placements in other huge Spotify playlists. Also, he's in the top 100 global Apple Music playlist, as well as other big Apple Music playlists also. And we all know your average consumer nowadays is discovering music through playlists, and labels use playlist placements as a way to spread artists, spread songs, and spread albums, so these definitely helped. However, this success has a lot to do with the insane community around Uzi's music also. If you're watching this video, you probably had a hand in helping these numbers and you don't even know it. The long wait that we've had to endure just made us so restless. But this, combined with Uzi's constant barrage on social medias over the last week or so, has led to huge impressions that spread the word about the album. Basically, anything that happened with Uzi in the last week went viral and trended. The trailer for the album trended on YouTube. That Way single trended on YouTube and in Spotify playlists. Eternal Atake trended on Reddit, Twitter, and was the fifth most trending topic on Google with over 500k searches when it dropped. Even the covers for the album trended on Twitter. Not to mention, even when Uzi went on talking about the deluxe version of the album, we saw multiple snippet names that aren't even officially released go trending on Twitter, which is insane and I don't think I've seen before. And on the topic of the deluxe album, I want you guys to tell me, if you guys had to pick one snippet to be released out of Lotus, Myron, and Kobe / Rolly, which one would it be and why? For me, although it's a hard choice, I think I gotta go with Rolly. I've just been waiting so long for that, but let me know what you guys have got. And all of this adds up to literally millions of impressions and thousands of people discovering the album is out. And this type of earned media is a type of promotion labels would pay thousands for. So to have a lot of it be free, organic fan interaction is huge and undoubtedly played a role in the success of the project. I just want to give a couple quick shout outs from my Instagram. Shout out to everyone who commented on my recent post and gave me their opinions on this album. And a couple of random picks, we have Cameron Emery, we have Soli Ramirez, we have JLock _ Money, we have Jerry. Appreciate all you guys showing me love. If you guys don't follow me at yadiiiig, you guys know what to do. Go follow your boy. Also, a reminder about my merch tees, guys. We see the whole lot of red right here. We only have larges left in the Carti, and we only have one medium left in this design. Link in the description to cop if you're interested. I put a lot of effort into getting the exact numbers and stuff for you guys, so I would appreciate it if you could like, subscribe, comment, turn on notifications, all that good YouTube stuff. But let's get back to this breakdown. Also, playing into the success of this album, we just saw Uzi be featured on G Herbo's, Lil Baby's, and A Boogie's projects all within the last couple weeks or so. So that, on top of Futsal Shuffle and That Way, helped to circulate his name in the conversation and get people outside of his core audience acquainted with Uzi again. And to the credit of Uzi, normally it's such an accepted thing nowadays to put all these big name features on your albums to help boost up the streams and make people check it out. But Uzi really went on a whim and only had Sid as a feature, who is a relatively small artist, and he was still able to pull in big numbers. He also did go the route of the album bundle merch deal with this sweatshirt right here, but honestly, this is a pretty small merch bundle push. We've seen other artists do all kinds of things with their album bundles, from huge concert merch releases and tour bundles like Travis Scott with Astroworld, to others who do all kinds of accessory album bundles to prop up their numbers. So realistically, we could have seen these numbers be considerably larger if there was more of a bundle push from the label and from Uzi. Plus, another thing to consider is the deluxe version of the album. With all the hype and anticipation from fans over longtime grails possibly being on there, like Kobe / Rolly, Myron, etc, etc, if his team is able to get the deluxe version out a couple days before the end of the streaming week, the streams and the earned media from the deluxe version would be huge and would prop up the numbers even more. And yeah, I don't know, overall from a commercial perspective for Uzi, this has been a huge success so far. I'm really happy for him that after all this time he's doing big numbers like this. As I said, I'm going to be following up tomorrow with my kind of review and my thoughts about the album, so make sure to stay tuned, subscribe, turn on notifications to check that out. At yadiiiig, make sure to follow me on Instagram, reminder about my merch pieces, link in the description to cop if you're interested, and there are more videos of mine on screen right now, make sure to check them out if you haven't.